This conference will now be recorded.
हेलो। हाँ गाइस, कैन यू हियर मी? हेलो।
यस सर।
ओके राइट। सो व्हाट वी डिस्कस्ड यस्टरडे, एनी डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग जेडीबीसी गाइस?
Sir, could you send this project to us, sir, because we did not get the recording for yesterday.
I am not sending recording. You did not receive any, nobody received yesterday recording. Hello? Yes, have you received the recordings, everyone?
No, sir. I think system issue, some system issue occurred yesterday. That's why they sent us the message like they couldn't record yesterday.
Okay. So you didn't get because they did not record. Okay, I'll inform them once again. Okay. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'll inform them.
Okay, sir. I think they sent us the message. There was some GoToMeeting issue. Therefore, they couldn't record the yesterday class.
No, they didn't inform me anything. Okay. If you don't get today also, you let me know. Message me somebody. Okay. Chalo. Guys, so we discussed about of creating statement and executing the statement. So execute query is used for what? For selecting the command. I mean, for selecting command, we use execute query. Okay, for insert, update, delete, which method we use? Execute, update method we use, correct? Execute, update is used for insert, update, delete and all. And only for select query, we use execute query method. Guys, and what the execute query method returns back to us, that is the result set. Okay, so result set is nothing but it contains the set of rows coming from the database table. Okay, and if you want to fetch each row from the result set, first you need to trace using next method, which returns true if there is a row. Okay, it returns false if there is no row. Got it? So again, if there is a row, it will just use that getter method to get the data from the result set using get string, get int, get double, guys. Okay, so we need to understand this very clearly. Today I'm going to discuss about prepared statement. Before that, let me do something else. Day dot three. This is select now. I'll just say four. Control A, Control C. Here I want to update record first, so let me go and statement st dot execute update. Because for insert, update, delete, everything we use execute update, and update employee set salary equals salary plus 1000 rupees, for example. I am adding 1000 rupees to the salary of each employee. Yeah, once it is executed, I am selecting the rows again and I am printing it. Let us run this code, see the output. See, Pasha 10,999, 9,787. Once again, let me run it. Now it will become like 11,000. Yes, 11,999. 10,000, 10,000. Guys, are you getting this effect here? Update effect. Are you getting update effect or not? Is the rows are being affected with update query or not? So in this program, if you observe, you are running what, two different queries. That's what I have shown you. I wanted to show you different queries. Guys, so one statement can run different queries. So here I what I want to show, one statement object. Guys, I am not creating multiple statement objects. Only one statement object is performing two different queries. One statement object performing two different queries. Okay, do remember this point. Now I am going to prepare statement. In the prepared statement, let us try to understand. JDBC demo. Copy. Control A, Control C. I'm copying this because most of the code is same, guys. That's what I'm copying rather than typing again and again. You can check here. I write the insert query. Yeah, what exactly I'm going to do is I'm going to work with a new statement called prepared statement. It is not a statement, prepared statement. java.sql.prepared, remember. Now we already seen statement, then what is the difference between prepared statement? We'll understand that also. Prepared statement. Rather than values, I'm giving question mark. See what it indicates. I'm not going to store values. Specific values. I'm going to store some values, but I don't know which values and how many values also. So when you are running for insert many times, I mean same query many times, if you want to insert multiple, for example, if you want to insert multiple rows, I mean same operation many times, then go for prepared statement. In the previous what I did, different query, yeah, two different queries when you are running, update select, insert select, update delete, update select, update insert, insert update, any different queries in the same program, one statement is enough to perform different queries. But when we go for prepared statement, if same statement running for many times, then we go for prepared statement. Okay, guys. Now let us understand by adding many rows in this program. So in the beginning, you see, I am saying I need insert, but I don't know exactly which values. But I know there are three values to be inserted. Which three values also exactly, I don't know. I place three question mark placeholders in order to put a values. Yeah, before executing the statement, I need to fill three values. while, let me go to repeated loop, do while loop. Why do while loop? I'll also take scanner class, so I will take the values from the dynamically at runtime. System dot in import saved. System dot out dot println enter ID. I ask the user to enter the ID. Next enter. I store that value into a variable called ID, guys. Then the ID which I have taken from the user, I need to set in the first question mark. So PST dot, where is that? Sorry, I need to change this name. PST. PST saved. PST dot set integer. And first question mark, the first paragraph, second one is value which I set. Guys, prepared statement I have created. Prepared the statement with query, but not values. The query is pre-compiled with question marks. And each question mark is placed by one value which is taken from the user. Okay, so user has entered ID. I'm setting that ID to the first question mark. Similarly, I'll take the value, enter name, string name equals sc dot next. Then PST dot set string, second question mark, name. Enter salary, double salary equals sc dot next double. Yeah, I take the salary and the same salary I need to set third question mark here. PST dot set double third question mark salary. See now what I did at the time of execution, I mean before execution, I set all the values to the question mark prepared statements. See, prepared statement initially without values, only placeholders. Later prepared statement, I set each question mark with the value. Finally, I execute the prepared statement here. Cut it, paste it here. See, PST dot execute update empty braces. X rows inserted. Then I will ask user, do you want more? Do you want more? Yes or no? Do you want more? Yes or no? Then sc dot next. I put like a string choice, a variable which holds yes or no, guys. So once I enter all the values and store in the database, then I will ask user, do you want more records to be added? If he wants yes or no, I will store in the variable called choice. And I say choice do while choice dot equals ignore case. Sorry, dot equals, why equals is not coming? Guys, choice is string now. The choice variable will declare as a string now. Why it is not getting equals method? Hello? Yeah. Anybody? I say choice dot equals, why methods are not coming? Choice dot equals, why methods are not coming? String methods. Anybody? Guys, anybody? why methods are not getting. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, why choice is not getting? Yes. Why choice is not getting? Why it is giving error? I already declared choice, but why it is giving error? Guys, I declared within the range of while, na, do while, na. But out of this range of while, okay, out of this close bracket, will choice will work? If you declare choice within the braces, will that work out of the braces? No. So what is the best practice in that case? Don't declare here. Go and declare outside the bracket or outside the try block. The best place anywhere globally, not even within the try. String choice. Look at this now. I say choice dot equals, is that working, guys? Why? Yeah, this is the code I'm writing for prepared statement. See, the advantage of prepared statement is what? When you want outline queries, I mean taking value input from runtime of the program, from the user, okay, rather than hard coding inside the program, then go for prepared statement. And same insert query, once it is prepared and many times it is executing with different values, replacing different values in the question marks, guys, this will repeat. This code will repeat. This will not be repeated. So once it is prepared, it is ready for inserting values, three values, I mean three columns, and you decide which value in those columns and execute many times. Prepared once, execute many times, guys. Copy. ID 500. Virat, do you want one row inserted? Guys, check here. Let me go and check my, in the command, my SQL. ROOT. SQL. Make sure small letters, not capital letters. Check here. Use DB underscore 830. Select the star from employee. See, guys, 100, 500. Virat is already added. But still my program is running. If I say continue, yes, it will again ask me why not to. Okay, and UV. Do you want? Yes. See, let me select again. UV is already inserted in my database. I don't want to continue. Say no, stop. It won't ask. Guys, like if you want to insert many rows, I mean same query, if you are running many times with different values, then go for prepared statement. Prepared statement is used for same query executing many times. When we go for statement, the statement is used when we go for different queries executing in a program. Multiple different queries are executing in the program. then go for statement. Okay, if same query many times, then go for prepared statement. Guys, this is the exact use or advantage of statement and prepared statement. Both are having their own capabilities based on the requirement. Now, somebody may ask, why, what is the difference? Why only statement like that? Because if you go for statement, there are some problems. What are the problems? Statement, whenever it executes, because you see, statement directly executing. Statement directly executing, execute, execute. I mean, at the time of execution, it always performs three operations. One, parsing. Number two, compiling. Number three, executing. I mean, every time, whenever you execute the query in database, it performs parsing. Okay, parsing means converting the statements into binary, and compiling, checking for errors and converting into the bytecode, then executing the finally. Like that, it will perform three operations, guys. And assume that if you are doing this, okay, and it may take 4 milliseconds, assume 4 milliseconds time for performing all these actions. So if you are entering 100 rows by using statement interface, tell me how many milliseconds will take. 400, right? Because every time it will parse, every time compile, every time execute. But I don't think when you are not changing the query, you no need to parse and compile every time. Okay, execution only required if you are doing the same query many times. Guys, tell me, if you are typing program and running, if you don't make any changes, do you need compilation or only execution directly? When you need compilation, when the code is got compiled, when you make any changes in the program, then compilation is required. If you don't make any change in the code, compilation is not required. Direct, you can execute the same query, same code, because previously compiled code can be executed because there is no change in the previous compilation. So why again we need to destroy and compile the code? Because when you don't need change, don't make any change. Similarly, like this, if you make changes, first query different, second query different, because it is doing every time all these processes, no? Parsing, compiling, execution, every process. So better we go with a statement. Why? Because first statement was update, second statement is different, not same. So again, it will do the same stuff, parsing, compiling, executing. So it is suitable here. Okay, 4 milliseconds better. But if you take this for multiple 100 rows, 400 milliseconds, guys. So it is not suitable. Now let us go to this process. Assume this is done only once. This is done only once at the time of compilation, at the time of preparation, and at the time of execution, it does not perform all of these. It will only perform execution process. So while executing, assume it take only 1 millisecond for execution, but for performing, same. Because parsing, compiling, again execution. But how many times are we doing this process? Only once. But how many times we are executing? 100 times. Now tell me, in this case, if you use prepared statement, how many total milliseconds? 100 plus 4, 104 milliseconds. Guys, tell me, 400 milliseconds is better, or 104 milliseconds is better? Guys, respond someone. Do you understand clearly?
It is only 5 milliseconds, sir.
What?
It is only 5 milliseconds, sir. For parsing, compiling, it is 4 minutes.
Yes.
Then for executing, it is 1 millisecond.
Yeah, why we need compilation again? Because the same query is executing now. Only values are replaced now. Query is not changed, right? Insert only insert. If insert converted into update, then you need to compile now. So once it is compiled, pre-compiled prepared statement being replaced the values and executing now. So this process many times is not required now.
Yeah, okay, sir.
If the query change from insert to update or insert to delete or insert to select again new query, then obviously you need all this again. So when you are using prepared statement, it will be done only once now and many times execution. So it's well suited for prepared statement or not? Guys, logically everybody understood what is the need of prepared statement or not?
Yes, sir.
If any confusion, you can ask me still. This is important interview point of question. What is the difference between statement and prepared statement, guys? So when use multiple queries, go for statement. When one query many times, go for prepared statement. Why? You give this kind of explanation here. Okay, so that's what I gave. One example with the different queries. And well suited for statement and other example for single query. Okay, guys. Right. So let me go with one more example. Yes.
So statement or many queries single time.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Different
statement, many queries. Yeah, different. Many different queries. Prepared statement. Well, same query many times. Okay, now.
Okay.
Result set. Why result set RST? Import. Here, what I will do is I'll write select query. From employee where emp id equals question mark. Emp id equals question mark. Okay, that means I want to write one query and I want to replace this question mark many times, like I'll remove this. Question mark, I will add ID. Okay, I will ask ID to enter, ID to display, ID to display employee, ID to display employee, and I need to set, I already set that question mark, then PST dot execute query, because select, it is the select. That's what query, and I will get result set. Yeah, tell me guys, if I want to display result set, what should I do? For result set, what should I do? Guys, JDBC, continue.
Getting
right.
Why loop?
How many rows will be there in result set? Do you know how many exactly rows?
We don't know, sir. R is not.
Why you don't know, ma? Why you don't know? See, you said where. Where means what? Condition, na? See, this is not like a star. Select a star from without condition all rows. Now, what do you mean by this where class, guys? Where class means what? Conditionally, you are getting where ID equal to 100, ID equal to 500, ID equal to 200. What do you mean by that? One person or many persons you are getting up?
Yeah, one, sir.
Only one, yes. So, do remember these points are important, guys. There is nothing in JDBC, very simple. only few points you need to remember and be active everyone. Guys, don't look at the code. It's very simple and easiest code I'm repeating. There is nothing new today. See, where class, it's a query. Where means condition, only one record, no more records. So result set contains how many records? Only one record. Now I don't go for while, because while is required only when you have multiple records. If because only one record, rs dot next, if rs dot next, yes, if result set dot next, then display. If only one row, no, id plus rs dot get int of one dot out dot println name rs dot get string of two system dot out dot println id name salary plus rs dot get double three third question mark sorry third column. That's it. So do you want more rows? Yes, I am looking for more rows. Now let me continue. Same query many times. Enter ID 101. Guys, you got Amit. Do you want to continue? Yes. Again, same query. 500. See, Virat. Again, same query. No. Stop. What do you understand? When I went for prepared statement, the same query is executing many times, guys. Same query executing many times. Yeah, prepared, yes, ones executing many times by taking new values. This is what the advantage of prepared statement, guys. Prepared statement and prepared statement, the difference you should very clearly understand all. And I am going to give you an assignment over here if you are clear with that. Anybody having any question here? Is there anybody having any question?
No, sir. No
question. Very good. So this is what JDBC. Okay. Now the assignment for you guys is read ID and amount from user, then update the amount or update the salary with or update the salary by adding the amount to the given person and display the record. I want this you to work on JDBC and show me. Read the ID and amount from the user, then add 100 rupees. For example, if I give 100 rupees for 500, means 500th record person, I want to add 100 rupees. I add, then I display that person's record. That person's record only, guys. Do remember, this is your assignment. Do you understand what is assignment, everyone? Guys,
yes, sir.
So by Monday, because tomorrow we don't have session, day after tomorrow we don't have Saturday, Sunday. I want to everybody to work and come back on Monday with this assignment. And as well as before we start on Monday, we are going to start a servlet, which is a part of web development, guys. Before we get into that, I want everybody to clear with the JDBC. In the web development, the recommendation prerequisite from you is HTML. Like here we worked with SQL, in web we work with HTML. Guys, we work with HTML. Okay, now, so if you don't know HTML, I want you to only look at this code. Actually, I will cover in the during the session, but still W3 schools anchor tag. First anchor tag, you learn about anchor tag HTML W3 school. There you will find example. A anchor tag example will be there. Try yourself. You can go and try yourself. It will tell you what do you mean by anchor tag. See directly, you can see the output. Code, understand. Okay, I want you to work and come back before I tell you. Guys, number one, anchor tag. Number two, you also go through form tag. Anchor tag, form tag, both. Form tag in W3 schools.
It's on news, sir. Go for all.
Form tag. You can check here, try yourself. Code is there. Just go through and try to understand yourself. See, this is submission. Just go through these two tags and come back in HTML. Okay, that's it. That is the prerequisite and this assignment of JDBC. Okay, if you could complete this all by Monday and we can continue the servlet. Guys, the first session of servlet is most important. Okay, don't try to miss the session. Otherwise, you don't understand the rest of the sessions. You need to struggle a lot. Because the first session is only the bit toughest session. Okay, if you understand the first session, then the rest of the session will be clear. Okay, so try to attend on Monday without fail, guys. Yeah, right. So the next point is, yeah. Kosh.
Yes, sir.
Your question, right?
Yes, sir.
Do you remember this we did?
Yes.
The same example he did there. The same example. What he did is thread. See, we created here, remember? We created thread class operate. And thread class object we placed. Rather than that, what he did is he put all this in place of this. That's what we call it, anonymous, not with the name, unknown. Got it?
Okay, sir.
So he created implemented class. Name. He created directly implemented class without name. There, what we did, we created a class, implemented class by implementing this runnable, then we created object of this, right? Then that object we placed. So directly he is creating implemented object. That's it.
Okay,
he's not creating object for runnable. He is not creating object for runnable. He is creating object for this class, implemented anonymous class. There is no name.
Okay. That means the new keyword there, he is using for my thread class, right? Like my
yes.
Thread.
No, not my thread class. This class. Yeah.
Anonymous class mean my thread class, but it, there is no name, right?
No name, right?
Oh, okay. That's it. I was wondering why he is
using. You can understand class. It's like a shortcut.
Oh, okay, sir. Now I understood.
I cannot write those shortcuts here. No, you people will kill me, right? This is only complex. Then in that complexity, I cannot add more complexity. That is runtime mode, real-time mode, right? So if you understand this, that can be easy. But that's not creating object for the runnable. It's implementation class. Okay? Okay. Now clear?
Yes, sir. Thank
sure.
you.
Sir. Right, guys. So bye. See you. Happy weekend. And I want at least you go through, come back. Yesterday's video, I will check with them and I try to arrange to send it to you. Okay, guys?
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Bye. See you on Monday.
Yeah, thank you.
Samyukta, what?
Anonymous class means it will be created only once.
The class without name. The class without name is anonymous class.
It will be deleted, sir. After
will be?
It will be created each and every time, sir.
Yeah, yeah, it automatically deleted, no?
It will be deleted immediately after exhibition.
Yes, by JVM, by JVM.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank
okay.
you.
Bye. Have you done, have you installed your MySQL, Samyukta?
Yes, sir. MySQL file is working, sir. It is not working, sir.
Sorry?
MySQL file is working, sir.
That's okay. Anyone, no problem. Don't worry. Maybe you already installed now, so there might be some conflict. Any MySQL is working or not?
Yeah, file only is working, sir.
It's okay. You can follow me then.
Yes,
it's okay. Okay,
okay.
No, bye. Bye.